no mercy. Set her down to spoil me my misery, beyond flesh and blood. Well, I'm miserable, I can turn that straight.
What are you talking about? What do you all dress that for?
As if you didn't know. Draw him back to that Wimpole's devil and tell him what he's done to me.
What has he done to you?
It's ruined me, that's all. Destroy me happiness. Tie me up and deliver me into the hands of middle-class morality. Don't you, detective? Was it him or was it not him? The wrote to a bloke named Waddingford, who was donating millions to found moral reform societies, and told him the most original moralist in all England was one Alfred P. Dewey, a common dustman.
That sounds like one of his jokes.
You make one, young chap. But the little bee rod enough. The bloke died and left me £4,000 a year, blooming well. Deepest cut of all. Just because I'm rich, your mother wants to marry me. Just because I'm respectable, she wants to be respectable.
But if that's the way you feel, why don't you give the money back?
That's the tragedy of you, Eliza. It's easy to say, chucking. But I have the nerve. You're intimidated, Eliza. That's what we are. That's what I am. Bought up. That's what your precious professor has brought me to.
Not mine.
Oh, sends you back, has he? First of all, he shoves me into the middle class, then he sends you back so I have to support you. All part of his plan. Don't you double cross him, Eliza. Don't you take tuppence from me. You stand on your own 2 feet. You're a lady now. You can do it.
Eliza, it's getting awfully cold in that taxi.
Here. You want to see me turn it off this morning? St. George's, Hanover Square, 10 o'clock. Wouldn't advise it, though. You're welcome.
Girl.
eyes will know what damage is gone.
Did I ever be gentleman frighten her last night?
You were there, Miss Jess. We hardly said a word. Higgins, you didn't bully the girl, did you?
Quite the other way. She threw the slippers at me without the slightest provocation. They came back in my head before I'd even uttered a word. And she used the most dreadful language. Poor.
I'm dashed.
I don't understand. She was shown every possible consideration. She admitted that herself.
But I'm dashed.
And Gregory, will you stop being dashed and do something about it?
What?
Call the police in heaven's sake. What else are they here for?
Mr. Higgins, you can't be listening to the police.
She belongs to me. I paid £5 for her, and I want her back.
Quite right. Hello, Scotland Yard, please. Miss Pierce, may I have some coffee?
Yes, sir.
Oh, good morning, other chap. This is Colonel Hugh Pickering here. 27 Leeward Posh Street. I'd like to report a missing person. Anything you can do to assist in their recovery would be frankly appreciated. I'm not without influence, and I'll see to it that you're severe. I'm Eliza Doolittle. About 21. I should say about 5'7". Her eyes?
Brown!
Well, it's the rather neutral non-street colour. I'll see the one from here.
Brown! Brown! Brown!
Ew, but he said brown. Yes, this is a residence. It's in 3 or 4 this morning. No relation at all. Let's just say good friends. Now, see here, good man. I was so pleased with the tenor of that question. The only girl in our series after. Your affair is to get her back so she can carry on doing it.
What is it all of heaven could have prompted her to go after such a triumph at the ball? What could have impressed her? What could have possessed her? I cannot understand all that at all. But exasperating, calculating, vacillating, agitating, maddening, and infuriating blanks!
Hello, who's the button, please? Yes, I'll wait. Pickering. Why can't a woman be more like a man?
Yes, why can't a woman be more like a man? Mr. Wallace, so far he's square. Eternally noble, historically fair. When you win, we'll always give your back a pint. Why can't a woman be like that? Why do they do everything the others do? Can't a woman learn to use her head? Why do they do everything the mothers do? Why don't they grow up like their fathers instead? Why can't a woman take after a man? Men are so pleasant, so easy to please. Why is thinking something we never do? Why is touching? Be like me!
Without you, you could turn it off. It's got no feelings to her.
are a devil. You can twist the heart in a girl as easily as some can twist the arms to her. What am I to come back for?
Of course, Eliza. That's what I took you all for in the first place.
And you may throw me out tomorrow if I don't do everything you want me to.
Yes, and you may walk out tomorrow if I don't do everything you want me to.
And live with my father.
Yes. Not so fast. Or would you rather marry Pickering?
I wouldn't marry you if you asked me, and you're nearer my age than what it is.
Then he is.
I'll talk as I like. You're not my teacher now. That's not what I wanted, don't you think? I've always had chaps enough wanting me that way. Pray you write to me twice and three times a day, sheep and sheep.
What you want me to be as infatuated about you as he is. Is that it?
No, that's not it. That's not the sort of feeling I want from you. I want it for kindness. I know I'm a common flower girl, and you're a book-learned gentleman, but I'm not dirt under your feet. What I've done, what I did, was not for the dresses and the taxes. I did it because we were pleasant together, and I can't. I came to care for you. Not to want you to make love to me, and not forgetting the difference between us, but more friendly.
Dear,
and how Pickering feels? Eliza, you're a fool!
That's not a proper answer to give
me. So will you get it, will you, Pop? Stop being a plain idiot. You've got to accept that some men won't spend half their time falling over you and the other half giving you black eyes. You'll find me cold, unfeeling, and selfish. They won't be off with you. Some sentimental hog or other with a pair of lips to kiss you with and a thick pair of boots to kick you with. If you can't appreciate what you've got, you'd better get on with someone you can appreciate.
I can't talk to you. You turn everything against me. I'm always in the wrong. But don't be too sure you have me under your feet to be trampled on and talked down. I'll marry Fred, I will, as soon as I'm able to support
him. That poor chap who couldn't get a job as an errand boy, even if he had the guts to try it. But you must understand, I have made you a consul for a king!
Freddy loves him. That makes him king enough for me. I don't want him to work. He wasn't brought up from Sarah. I'll go and be a teacher.
You said I think a woman would succeed, I'd be wiser, more magnificent. 5 minutes ago you were a millstone round my neck. Now you're a tower of stone, a consort for a battleship. I like you this way.
Goodbye, Professor. I shall not be seeing you again.
Mother! That suits her. She's an owl, sickened by a few days of my sunlight. I can do without her, I can do without anybody. I have my own spark of divine fire.
Grateful she's corner of Tottenham Court Road. But the one claiming us at Tallmoor Junior.